exercise is hands down the best current way to add healthy years to your life and raise the chance of hitting your 100th birthday so that you can dominate the local senior pickleball league for decades. A proper exercise routine focuses on improving your strength, cardiovascular fitness, and balance/stability. Find out if your fitness is on par with these six simple science-backed tests. The first test, the sitting rising test, is a great indicator of your overall flexibility, coordination, balance, and strength. It assesses your ability to sit on the floor and stand back up again, which studies have found is linked to your risk of death. Here's how it works. Cross one leg over the other and gracefully sink into a sit on the floor. Once you're down, stand back up. But here's the kicker. No touching the floor with anything other than your feet and keeping your balance. This means no hands, no knees, no elbows, no forearms, and definitely no side of the leg action. Now it's time to get your score on. Start with a perfect 10 and deduct 1 point for each hand, knee, forearm, or wobbly moment on the side of one leg. Here's what the results mean. 2012 study found that those with a score below 8 were riding the express train to a mortality showdown, facing double the risk of departure within the next 6 years compared to those with high scores. Those in the 3 or less score club were on a bullet train to the afterlife with a 5-fold increased risk of death. But don't panic if you scored low, because boosting your SRT score by just 1 point could bring your risk of early death down by 20%. The next test is a great proxy for your overall strength by testing your hand grip strength. Grip strength is highly linked to risk of chronic disease like cardiovascular disease and cancer, and longevity. Poor grip strength can even uncover genetic defects that increase the risk of heritable heart disease. So the take-home message is, the stronger you are, the healthier and longer you'll live. The most accurate way to test your grip strength is to use a device called a dynamometer. One study showed that an 11-pound loss in grip strength on a dynamometer increased the risk of all-cause mortality by 16%. This means that the weaker your grip strength, the higher your chance of contracting a chronic disease or dying early. Since most of us don't have a dynamometer lying around, dead hangs are a great alternative to find out and to train your grip strength. Dead hangs are easy to do. Find a pull-up bar and hang for as long as you can with your hands pronated at shoulder width or slightly wider apart. Men should be able to hang for at least 60 seconds, while women should aim for a minimum of 30 seconds, according to Dr. Andy Galpin. Anything less than that raises your risk of premature death significantly. Sounds about time to get that pull-up bar installed in your office. Another test that assesses your strength is the push-up test, which focuses on your upper body strength. The test is straightforward. Warm up and do as many consecutive push-ups as you can. The goal should be at least 40 push-ups for men and 20 for women. One study found that men who can do less than 10 push-ups had a 30 times greater risk of heart disease compared to those who could do 40 or more. Yowzers, time to train those pecs. Next, let's talk about a couple of tests that determine your cardiovascular health. The first is resting heart rate, or RHR, the number of times your heart beats per minute. RHR is a good proxy for how efficient your heart is and your general cardiovascular fitness. To measure your RHR, bring your heart rate to baseline by sitting down for 5 minutes. Turn your left palm up and place 2 fingers on your wrist. Once you find your pulse, count the number of beats for 1 minute. Your goal is to have an RHR of less than 60 beats per minute for men and 65 for women. This is because RHR is inversely correlated with death from any cause and cardiovascular disease, meaning that the higher the RHR, the more likely you will die from heart disease or other causes. One paper showed that men with RHRs greater than 75 were twice as likely to die from any cause compared to men with RHR values of less than 55. The next test to assess your cardiovascular fitness is called VO2 max, or maximal oxygen consumption. VO2 max is a measure of the maximum amount of oxygen that an individual can use during intense exercise. VO2 max is typically expressed in milliliters of oxygen per kilogram of body weight per minute. The higher the VO2 max, the better an individual's aerobic fitness and cardiovascular health. VO2 max is best measured in a lab while hooked up to a mask, wearing a heart rate monitor, and riding on a bike or running on a treadmill. Getting to a sports medicine lab is obviously a big barrier for most people. Luckily, there are ways to approximate your VO2 max with wearables such as certain Apple, Garmin, and Fitbit watches, or using these formulas. See the link in the description below. Ideally, you want to shoot for higher VO2 max than average, which is the 50th percentile in this chart, based on your sex and age range. There are mounds of evidence showing that there is a strong connection between higher VO2 max and increased longevity and prevention or delay of chronic diseases. For instance, going from low, below the 25th percentile, to below average, 25th to 50th percentile, reduced the chance of dying by over 50% in the next decade, while going from low to above average resulted in up to 70% decrease in mortality over the next decade. Amazing. The simplest fitness test in this video is the 1 foot balance test, which assesses your strength and balance. To perform this test, balance yourself on 1 foot while standing. Sounds simple enough, doesn't it? A 2021 study found that middle-aged and older adults unable to balance on 1 foot for at least 10 seconds were close to twice more likely to die in the next 10 years, even after accounting for factors such as age, sex, BMI, history of heart disease, hypertension, diabetes, and cholesterol. Time to work on our tree poses. Now that you know how to assess your fitness at home, it's time to set goals to keep improving your strength, cardiorespiratory health, and balance. Achieving higher levels of fitness will produce health and longevity benefits that no current pill can replicate. Yet. Watch these videos to see the medical technologies that will mimic some of the benefits of exercise to revolutionize our health and lifespans. Also, if you want to know how to design your exercise routine to improve your fitness, then comment below.